Hi there, YouTube. So, as you can see, I have a new tripod. A great, big, huge new tripod. So, you've just seen me unbox it. It's made by a company called Artcise. Back when I got my three-legged thing tripod, I was actually looking at another company called Leo Photo. Now they did a kind of a knockoff of the Gitzo and Really Right Stuff heavy duty, big thick chunky tripods like these. But in the end I went with the three legged thing. And then not long after that, Leo Photo seemed to just disappear. But then recently I started seeing these on eBay and on Amazon, and I looked at a few reviews and decided to get one. So it's huge, as you can see. It's got a huge collar and base on it, which you can see there. I've only just opened it up, so I don't really know much about it. They feel really smooth. And it kind of locks into place when you pull it down. So once you get it there, it kind of locks, so you have to twist it to get it to go back up. It's massively long. So it's perfect for somebody of my height. These feel really sturdy, thick and chunky. It's got huge rubber feet on it, as you can see. It's got these really nice, those catches feel really smooth. Yeah, they're very smooth, they are. Feel really good quality. So you just push it in. And there you go. And the thing about it is it doesn't come with a center column, so you can literally sit it on the floor if you want to, which you can't do with the three-legged thing Winston, because, well, it's got a center column. They feel super smooth, they do. Really like those. There's a twist, and out they come. And it's just, look at the carbon fibre. Look how thick that carbon fibre is. Now it feels quite a bit heavier than the three-legged thing tripod. Doesn't come with a ball head, but I've got two or three spare ball heads. And I'm gonna be ordering one specifically for this one. Now, let's have a look at some of these accessories that it comes with. There we go. Now, this is part of the reason why I wanted this tripod. It comes with this self-leveling kind of bowl, which you just unscrew that, I believe. Crikey, that's quite long, isn't it? There we go. Okay, so that replaces this by, you just flick that catch up. Now there's another catch and another button underneath that flips that out, and then you just drop that. No, you don't. There's another bit. The the base, which is in here. That, and this is all metal, it's not plasticky, that drops in there like so. Tightens up to that. Now, when you're in the field, you sort of got a bubble level there. So once you've got your tripod reasonably leveled up, you can make fine adjustments with that, you see. Isn't that cool? So if you're on a bit of a uneven ground, you can just make a fine adjustment with that, tighten it up, and that's going nowhere. Super steady. The other piece that goes in there comes with a huge metal hook. You can hear that that's metal, to hang like your camera bag or something off. Although the size of this thing, I cannot imagine what on earth could make it unsturdy or blow it over so that you would actually need that. The feel of the carbon fibre is just beautiful. It's super smooth. It looks really high quality. I read that it's 8 layers of carbon fibre. All of this is metal. There's no plastic bits on it. The only plastic bit is this little handle here. This center leveling head handle. Everything else feels like really good quality metal. So I am super pleased with that. The only thing that could fail on this are the twist locks. So provided, actually it says on here, no, it's not 8, it's 10 times carbon fiber. And it says it's a dust resistant system. So these are apparently dust resistant. I am so pleased with this, I think it's awesome. The only thing that concerns me a little bit is the weight. So there's one more thing that comes with it. And that is, yes, here we are. It comes with a set of spikes that go in on the legs. So yeah, you've got a set of spikes there, look, and a set of Allen wrenches. So those spikes can go, the feet unscrew, the rubber feet, and then you can put the spikes on. So if you're on some ground that's boggy or soft grass or anything like that, whack those in, you're good to go. And it comes with a really nice quality bag. This carry case is, feels lovely quality. It's padded. It looks like it's a waterproof material. It's got thick, heavy duty straps on it. It's got a little side zip bag there. Now, I probably won't use this because actually I might use it just to keep this in the car. Stop it getting scratched. I'm just rolling around in the back of the car. But when I actually go out, I probably won't use this because I'll be carrying it on my camera bag. So let's get out and use it. Hi YouTube, thank you for joining me. So we're out and about now. Got the new tripod on the back of my camera bag. As you saw there, I've put a ball head on it. It's only a cheapy sort of KNF concept
ball head, but it's one I've got knocking around spare. I do have a new one on order. It's going to be a low profile, a new design ball head by. But for now, this ball head does the job. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just a cheap one. So it'll do for now. Anyway, I've come to, you may remember in a previous video I said that of all the types of woodland that you can go to and photograph, the one I find the most difficult is pine forest. And the reason for that is because it's also uniform. Most of it tends to be, in this country at least, tends to be plantation, sort of fairly new forest. I mean, these trees are gigantic, but they do grow very fast, and it's a plantation forest. It's a renewable forest, basically. But this is the type of woodland that I find the most difficult, because when I'm in an oak forest or beech or a woodland with lots of varied trees, I can look for different shapes in the branches. I can look for, you know, different patterns in the moss that covers them, different patterns in the bark. There's always lots of interesting patterns and shapes to look for that kind of fires the imagination. Whereas in a pine forest, everything looks exactly the same. So I find it difficult. But the only way to get better at it is to practice. So you can see then from when I was setting the tripod up just how high this thing is. The length of it is absolutely phenomenal. It's huge. And it couldn't be more a perfect height for me. I'm 6'3". As you can see, no center column. Great big massive collar, base on there. It's absolutely rock solid on the ground. And the camera is at eye level. Just going to level it up a little bit. So at the moment I don't have the leveling base on. Now there's a little catch here that if you flick it up like that, I can now pan the camera on the base. Push it back down and it doesn't move. So that's nice. The only problem now is I can't see the top of the camera very good. So I need to change my ISO to 50, because that's the ISO that I like to shoot at. I need to close my aperture down to F11. And then I need to open my shutter speed up until I can actually see something on the back of the camera. I'm just so impressed with this tripod. It's fantastic. I am very impressed with it. Right. Okay, let's talk about photography now rather than tripods for a moment. So, I think I may have found a composition. I just need to zoom in. Yeah, might need to use the long lens for this one. Okay, so I've got the 70-300 on. So hopefully now I can zoom in on my composition properly. Ah, that's better. So there is my composition. Okay, so I'm shooting a small group of these pine trees, but I've singled out a group that have in particular quite a large amount of moss around the bases. So that's about the only interesting feature that separates any of these trees, is the moss. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 trees in particular, and then lots and lots of trees in the background, but there's quite a bit of fall off. Now, I don't know if you know this, but if you don't, then it's quite a useful tip. Just give me a moment. The light's breaking through the clouds, so I'm going to take this shot. There we go, I got it. Light's looking really good at the moment. 2.5 seconds, F11. Underexposing quite a bit, like I normally do. Just going to take another one. Okay, right. Now, what I was trying to explain to you is this. When you use a long lens, when you zoom in to, let me see what I'm zoomed into. Okay, so I'm zoomed in at the moment to about 135, 135 millimeter. So even with a small aperture, which gives you depth of field, you're still going to get fall off because you're zooming your lens in. So even at F16, you would still get some fall off. Your background will still blur out a little bit. So the foreground trees are quite sharp. The ones in the distance are going to fall off and be a little bit more blurred, but I'm okay with that. I'm happy with that because it can, if in post I put a bit of a vignette around the scene, then that will add to the kind of ethereal mood of the photograph. But as I said, it's hard. I find it really hard in pine forest. Anyway, this video is more about the tripod than any photographs I get, and it's just superb. I love it. So whilst I still love my three-legged thing, Winston tripod, and that won't be going anywhere, by the way. I'm not going to sell it or anything. I should be hanging on to that. But I do love this tripod. I don't have to bend down, I don't have to use a centre column. It's the perfect height for me, for somebody tall like me. On the backpack, it didn't feel that much heavier, to be honest. I thought it would, but it doesn't. I like the fact that on the tops of the legs, you've got like a foam coating, so that when you carry it, doesn't matter which leg you carry, because it's really cold today, and when I put my hands on the carbon fibre, it's freezing. Whereas on the foam bits, it's okay. Now, the price of it. Now, the tripods that it's obviously inspired by, I'm not going to say it's a rip-off or a knock-off, because, you know, how much innovative design can you put into a tripod, given it's just three legs with a device on the top to hold your camera? There's only so much you can do to it. But the tripods that it's inspired by, such as Gitzo and Really White Stuff, which are the ones that you find that are designed like this, that are really big, they come in at sort of 1200, 1500, I've even seen them over £2,000. That's with a ball head on it. So if I said this thing cost about 800 quid, you think, okay, not bad. Or maybe even 600 or 500. I sound like a market trader now, don't I? It cost £299. Can you believe that? So it's all made of magnesium alloy. There's no plastic on it. The legs are carbon fibre. You get all the accessories with it, like the spike feet, the levelling bowl head that goes on it, and it's superbly made for 300 quid. That's crazy, isn't it? By the time I've bought a ball head for it, which I'm going to spend no more than 100 quid on, it'll have cost about just less than £400 for a pro level, super sturdy, fantastic tripod. I love it. Right, I'm going to end there. Thank you very much for joining me. I think you'll agree this is a pretty fantastic tripod. So if you're in the market for a new tripod and you want something super sturdy and high quality, then definitely check these out. You'll find them on Amazon. They're called Artcise, spelled Artcise. And this one is the AS90C, which I think is the biggest one that they do. Yeah, I'm super happy with it. I just can't wait to get a nice ball head for it, because this one, although it works fine, it looks a bit weird because it's so small. So yeah, thank you for joining me. Sorry it was a bit sort of thin on the ground with in terms of photographs. If you like the video, then give us a thumbs up. Also, if you haven't already, then consider subscribing. Please leave a comment as well, and I'll see you in the next video.